Tonight, just released police body cam footage shows the moment Casey White is taken into custody, ending a nationwide manhunt. This video shows the chaotic moment authorities in Indiana caught Casey and Vicky White after a brief chase ended with their getaway car flipped on its side. Investigators believe Vicky White shot herself as officers closed in.
We could hear her on the line saying she had her finger on the trigger. Shot victim. Female is still armed.
So this is obviously a very dark ending to a story, a sort of shocking surprise story that began at the beginning of last week of Casey White, who you saw in that video, and Vicky White, not related. Her using her position as a corrections officer to help spring him from jail. They then went on the run, and we're gonna give you the details. We'll put up a photo to remind you of these two. JR, we had talked about the initial search for them. I was pretty dubious about whether they'd be able to find them because I thought she knows law enforcement a little bit. They've got a lead and everything, but they tracked him down relatively quickly, and it ended in tragedy with her apparently shooting herself, according to what they say, narrowly avoiding a shootout with the cops. The cops at least say that they think that was the plan. What do you make of this?
It's sad. I remember from the beginning when we were talking about this, and there was the speculation, and I think it was fine to speculate that she's potentially another victim rather than accomplice in this. It's fine to assume that because you'll find out the truth soon enough, and they did, and they discovered that she's part of this whole thing, which ended this way. And I think what stood out to me, and I feel like I mentioned it, maybe I just thought it. Anytime you have corrections officers or police officers that have gone rogue or gone to the criminal life, they definitely don't want to go to jail. That's what they do know, especially people who work in prisons like she did. She's like, oh my God, there's no way I'm going to go to jail. That's a horrible place to be. And would rather kill herself than do so. Again, allegedly is what they said has happened. Kill herself rather than go there, which means a lot. So I'm curious. I'm surprised that they're still in the country. She sold her house for like significantly less than what it was worth for them to have some money. You think they would have been off somewhere else by now. Apparently they're not as smart as they thought they were.
Yeah, I mean, look, it immediately seemed like a horrible decision, a horrible plan, and it ended up, you know, in some form like you might have predicted. And yeah, they didn't get far. They drove 100 miles before dumping her Ford Edge. They got a pickup truck. They drove another couple hundred miles. And then that was pretty much it. Their car got rammed off the road into a ditch. She apparently shot herself. They said they were shocked that they would have stayed in a community like Evansville for 6 days, but apparently they were just too terrified that they would get caught, and they were right to. They were found on surveillance footage, I believe, at a car wash, and tracked down relatively quickly. So, I mean, there's no like good person in this story. It's just the whole thing. Just
they washed their car
needless and
while on the run.
I know. I guess that was one of the last things that they would do as free people, unfortunately. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.